Hi there. I'm Michael Brindisi, the president and artistic director of the Chanhassen Dinner Theatres. And I'm here to welcome you to CDT Variety Slam, Part 2. But before we get going, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the audience and our loyal customers for their support during these trying times. We appreciate your patience and hope to be with you soon. Now, we'd like to present Variety Slam 2. Some of our actors put together some videos for your entertainment. I think you'll recognize some from The Music Man and some from shows of the past. So sit back and enjoy CDT Variety Slam Part 2.
Does anyone know where this is?
For those of you who have not been on the roof of the Chanhassen Dinner Theatres, that's what it looks like. Hi, I'm Shad from the Barbershop Quartet of The Music Man.
And I'm Andy, and I'm the music director for the Dinner Theatre. And we moved to Chanhassen in January of this year so we could be closer to work. And now here we are.
During this time of social distancing, Shad and I are really looking forward to the day that we can all gather again in person and create the memories that really only live theater can provide us. But until that time, we've thrown together a little treat for you guys that we're gonna do right now.
When I think of home, I think quarantine, I think I'm here for a while. So I stay at home watching Tiger King while wearing socks and a smile. Come on, Joe Exotic, it's just you and me now, and whoever else pops up on my TV now. I don't know what day it is as I snack and hijack the whiz. Suddenly my world's gotten pretty weird, a little listless and lazy. What if I leave home and it's as I feared, and I've gone more than stir crazy? If you're listening, God, please don't make it hard for me to get back to reality. Tell us, should we still shake hands, and must we still wear pants, or are we losing our humanity? Oh, living in this brand new world might be a fantasy, but alone is alone, just for now. In the curb, somebody knock on my door, somebody say, April Fools, let's go to the store. Community pools, get in and I'll drive. Being alive, being alive. I'm tap, tap, tapping on the glass, wading through a window. You can hug me till I scream, if it's only in a dream, but please don't touch me. You can feel me till I squeal, just as long as it's not real, but please don't touch me. See him in the street, back up 6 feet, mask up and please have pity. And he used to love it uptown, it's quiet uptown, he is working through some social distancing. but the sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your unemployment that tomorrow we'll be back. If not, then tomorrow is only a metaphor for when we are back on track. In a world full of love like yours and mine,
we'll see you guys hopefully soon. Bye.
Hi, I'm Serena Brooke, and I play Alma Hicks in The Music Man at Chanhassen Dinner Theatres. This is my husband, Nick White, and he is a musician in town and has played in several shows at Chan. And both of our Chanhassen debuts were made during Fiddler on the Roof in 2013. So that's a very special show to both of us. So we're going to sing a song from that show with a few tweaks, because after all, it is a new world.
Do you love me?
Do I what?
Do you love me?
Do I love you? With our friends not getting married and this trouble in the town, you're upset, you're worn out, stay inside, go lie down. Maybe it's indigestion.
Serena, I'm asking you a question. Do you love me?
You're a fool.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love you?
Well?
For 45 days I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals.
I cooked like 3 times this week.
Cleaned your house, given you haircuts, milked the cow. After 45 days, why talk about love right now?
Serena, the first day of quarantine was on a Saturday. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd tolerate each other.
That's true.
Now I'm asking Serena, do you love me?
I'm your wife.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love him? For 45 days I've lived with him, fought with him, drank with him. For 45 days my space is his. If that's not love, what is?
So you love. I love you too. It doesn't change a thing, but even so,
after 45 days, to be honest, we are very lucky to be quarantined together, and we send a big, huge hug and lots of love to anybody out there quarantining by themselves. Vicky loves you. We'll see you soon.
Hi, everyone. I'm Tamara Kangas Erickson, Vice President and Choreographer at Chanhassen Dinner Theatres. Dance is such an important part of what we do in our musicals. So for tonight, we thought we would put together a compilation of some great dance clips from our history to share with you.
Thank you. Hey, Chanhassen Dinner Theatres Variety Slam. My name is Jay Albright, and today for you, I am going to
shave for you. I shaved for the Variety Slam. Thank you, Variety Slam. I needed that. Did I miss a spot? I hope I didn't. Okay. Yes, my name is Jay Albright. I've been working at the Chanhassen Dinner Theatres on and off, mostly on, since 1990. In fact, my first rehearsal was the day after Christmas, 1989. I started out there playing the kids, and now I'm playing the dads. It's been an absolutely beautiful place to work. I'm in love with the space. Some of the best years of my life have been spent there. Well, almost all the years of my adult life. Some of the worst years of my life, I suppose, too, have been spent there. I love it. I love it. I'm going to tell an anecdote. Once we were doing a production of Anything Goes. I was playing the role of Moonface Martin. I forget what year this was. I think both my kids were born. I'm not sure. And I was on stage and somebody barely missed an entrance. I'm not going to say who. They were a big fan of the Denver Broncos and the Denver Broncos were having a big game and she was just barely late. Nobody would have noticed, but it was just enough to put the fear of God in my head. And I thought, well, this is Anything Goes. I'm playing Moonface. I should have a joke to tell in case anybody ever misses an entrance, you know? So I chose a joke, and the very next performance, somebody missed an entrance. Two actors literally asleep backstage. I'm on stage with Keith Rice, and it was a big entrance. It was like, okay, ladies and gentlemen, these guys. I said, these guys, and these guys don't enter. They're asleep backstage. Keith Rice says, I'll go fetch these guys. He runs off stage to go get them, and I thought, I have a joke. So I turned to the audience, and I told the joke. I'm going to tell it to you now. Stop me if you've heard it, which is hilarious. You can't stop me. This is a video. So, baby polar bear comes home from school, says, Mom, am I a polar bear? And Mom says, yes, darling, of course you're a polar bear. Here, have a snack. Take a break before your homework. Next day, baby polar bear comes home from school, says, Mom, I'm a polar bear, right? She says, of course you're a polar bear. Says, and you and Dad, you're both polar bears? Yeah, we're polar bears. Here, have a snack. Take a break before you got to do your homework. Then I look off to the right, and I see the two guys desperately trying to get on stage. They're embarrassed. They fell asleep. They're trying to get on stage. Why wouldn't they? Keith Rice has them in headlocks. Don't you dare go on stage until Albright has finished his punchline. So I finished my punchline. Next day, Polar Bear comes home from school and says, okay, Mom, here we go. I'm a polar bear, right? Yes, darling. Of course you're a polar bear. You and Dad, both polar bears. She's a little upset. Of course, we're both polar bears. But what about your parents? What about Dad's parents? Is everybody a polar bear? She says, yes. Darling, everybody's a polar bear, all the way back. Why you gotta ask? And he says, because I'm freezing. Because I'm freezing. Whenever I'm looking in the mirror while wearing the shirt, I see the trouble spelled backwards is Elbort. Okay, next, I am going to show you a project that my family and I were working on. My son has recently declared a theater major at college. Arg, theater major, what was he thinking? But because of this lovely pandemic that's bringing families all over the world together, he was stuck in a house when he had to do a directing exercise for his directing class. So he cast his little brother, his mother, local actress Angela Timberman, and myself, local actor Jay Albright, to be in Act 4, Scene 3, a little snippet of Act 4, Scene 3, from Measure for Measure. Enjoy.
Sarah! Bring Bonadine hither!
My friend, you must rise and be hanged. Master Barnardine!
What ho! Barnardine!
The box of your throats! Who makes that noise there? What are you?
Your friend, sir, the hangman. You must be so good, sir, to rise and be put to death.
Away, you rogue! Away! I'm sleepy.
Tell him he must awake. And that quickly, too.
Pray day, Master Barnadine! Wait till you are executed and sleep afterwards!
Go into him and fetch him out!
He is coming, sir! He is coming! I can hear his straw rustle!
How now, Porson? What's the news with you?
Truly, sir, I would desire you to clap into your prayers. For look you, the warrant's come.
You rogue. I have been drinking hard all night, and I will have more time to prepare me, or they shall beat out my brains with billets. I will not consent to die today.
Oh, the better, sir, for he that drinks all night and is hanged betimes in the morning may sleep sounder all the next day.
Oh, look you, sir! I swear I will not die today for any man's persuasion!
Okay, now I am going to sing one of my favorite little songs by Harold Arlen and Yip Harburg. With apologies for my out-of-tune piano. Sorry about my out-of-tune piano. Here we go. Stop me if you've heard it. I could while away the hours, conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. And my head, I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching, if I only had a brain. I'd unravel any riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain. This is the pain chord. It'll come back. With the thoughts, I'd be thinking I could be another Lincoln if I only had a brain. I could think of things I'd never thunk before, and then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nuffin, my head all full of stuffin, my heart all full of pain. And perhaps I'd deserve you and be even worthier of you if I only had a brain.
Okay. Bye, Variety Slam. I love you. Thank you for coming. Come back anytime. This can't last forever. Bye, Variety Slam. You're awesome. See you around.
Hi guys, it's Laura Osnes. I am so honored to be joining this week's Variety Slam. I grew up going to shows at the Chanhassen and was lucky enough to make my debut in Music Man there in 2003, I think, and then returned to the stage at Chan to play Sandy in Grease in 2006. I love coming home to see shows and visit all my friends. I miss the Chanhassen family so much. Hope you guys are all hanging in there and doing well. I thought I would bring you a little joy from my own little corner here in Connecticut. I'm as mild and as meek as a mouse. When I hear a command, I obey. But I know of a spot in my house where no one can stand in my way. In my own little corner, my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be. On the wing of my fancy, I can fly anywhere, and the world will open its arms to me.
different kind of air. Just as long as I stay in my own little corner, all alone in my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be. I'm a thief in Calcutta, I'm a queen in Peru, I'm a mermaid dancing upon the sea, I'm a hunter's song in African safari. It's a dangerous type of sport, and yet it's fun. In the night I sally forth to seek my quarry, and I find I forgot to bring my gun. I am lost in the jungle all alone and unarmed when I meet a lioness in her lair. Then I'm glad to be back in my own little corner, all alone in my own little
Well, I hope you enjoyed CDT Variety Slam Part 2. Of course, we hope to be with you soon in our beautiful theater live. So in the meantime, be healthy, be safe. If you go out, wear a mask, wash your hands, and keep your eye out for the next CDT Variety Slam. See you later.